When living in Japan, service members and their families are bound to experience many changes from what they are used to in the U.S. From the culture, to the language, to the laws, some of which may be unknown to new residents. Chief James Robinson, a spectrum manager at the Navy and Marine Corps Spectrum Office in Yokosuka, says that those living in Japan need to be aware that certain wireless devices are not authorized while stationed here, because they may cause harmful interference to things such as cellular phone systems.
Well, for wireless devices that come from the States, they're not really authorized here in Japan because they operate on a different frequency. So there are special markings that are listed that folks here need to adhere to, because we are visitors here in Japan, so we need to obey the Japanese law.
Robinson said some of the most troublesome devices are baby monitors and wireless phones brought from outside of Japan. When they receive reports of interference, they are able to track and discover the source of the problem.
We receive reports, and they give us these little photos here, and it lets us know exactly a general location or where we need to go to identify the interference or EMI.
For more information, you can call the Spectrum office at 243-2366. Petty Officer Brian Record, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.